If you're using design patterns on a regular basis, then you must have already noticed that they often only bring a limited benefit to the design. But that can change. In this video, I will show you the greatest secret of design patterns. Any design pattern will get you only so far, but if you can combine them, oh, that is a different story. Combining design patterns can bring a fundamental shift into the way you design your classes. Let me show you. This is the interface, which requires several design patterns to implement properly. It is just letting the colors calculate the discounts that apply to some item given its input price. The output of this method is 0, 1 or multiple discount applications. It is very flexible. When I say 0 discount applications, here is one concrete implementation of the discount interface. The null object pattern applied. An object of this class will never return any discount. If you don't want a discount, then inject this object in place where the discount interface is expected. And here is the regular discount. It multiplies the price by the factor. But where are the patterns? I want to see patterns. Here, this is the composite design pattern applied. It is managing 0 or more other discounts and combining them into one object. Applying a chain of discounts is complicated, and hence there is the separate class implementing the composite design pattern, which does precisely that. More patterns. Where are more patterns here? This is the class implementing the decorator. It wraps another discount, a single one, and removes any zero amounts that might sneak out from that object. We don't want to see zero discounts displayed anywhere in the UI or in any report. Here's another decorator, a very interesting one. It is capping the total discount so that the sum of all discounts applied to an item in the shop will never be greater than what the shop owner allows. Now, the power of all these patterns we have here is in composition. Here, the composition root, I'm creating an object graph which implements the iDiscount interface as well, but I'm creating it by combining multiple objects under the hood. There is the title, the book title prefix discount, 17%. Then there is a relative discount, 12%. These two are running in parallel, that is, they are wrapped into the parallel discounts composite object, which applies both objects, both discounts to the same original price and sums them up. Then we remove the zeros from any stream of discounts produced by this composition and eventually cap the discounts to what? 25%. This is a very interesting composition of objects which is using three design patterns, the decorator, another decorator, yes, and a composite, two distinct design patterns in three objects. You already see here what is the great power of design patterns in combining them, but I'm not satisfied. There must be more. There must be more. Let me show you. Can we reap the benefits of that combining effect on a regular class? So this is that parallel discounts class that was used over there in the composition root. It is yet another composite implementation. It contains many discounts, possibly 0. When it comes to managing these multiple discounts, we see a very complicated piece of logic. As I said, each discount contained in this composite applies to the original price. But the problem here is that the sum of those individual discounts could become greater than the price, so the shop would have to pay to its buyers eventually. We don't want that. So there is the running sum. When the sum of all discounts becomes larger than the input price, we cap the last element in the output sequence and quit. That makes this class very complicated, and I would argue needlessly complicated. Here's the bright idea. Why don't we just let every discount do what it normally does, return whatever it wants, and then we take the result of those many individual discounts and cap them to 100% of the original price. Because we already have the decorator which is capping the discounts. We already have that feature implemented elsewhere. What do you say about that idea? Remove all the logic here, just apply many discounts, but then wrap the instance of this class into an instance of the capping decorator set up to cap to 100% of the original price. Wonderful idea. It's a pity that it won't work if the one who constructs the objects forgets to combine those two objects. What if the user of this class just forgot to apply the decorator to an instance of this class? Well, that is a dangerous situation, obviously. What do we programmers do when we face a problem like this one? An instance of this class must always be decorated with a specific decorator object. Well, if that is what must be done, then we do it ourselves. I will ensure that no instance of this class can ever exist unless wrapped inside the decorator which will cap it to 100% of the original price. That is the task for us to implement here. And if you want to see the source code of this demo before and after this change, then let me tell you that the source code is available to sponsors of this channel. So become the sponsor, help me keep this channel free for everyone else, and get access to source code of this demo and all other demos in all videos on this channel. There is the link to my Patreon page in the description where you can become a patron of my channel. Thank you very much for that. Now, let me show you the solution to this problem we have. Since we are constraining the construction of this object, of the object of this class, I will first turn the constructor private to gain the control of the construction process. There will be no way for anyone to just instantiate this class. I will be instantiating the objects of this class. And I will expose a factory method instead. Yet another design pattern factory method. This factory method will instantiate the parallel discounts object, but then do what it must. Cap it to 100% of the input price. Wrap it into a decorator. Do you like this? This idea is ingenious, really. Let me show you how smart it is. Look at this method. It's 9 lines of code plus 6 braces. 14 out of 15 lines of code are dedicated to what? To capping. Making sure that the sum of discounts never breaches the amount available. Defensive code. Desperate defensive code. Let me remove them. I want to retain that one line of code which is really doing the job of this class. This is that single line of code which is doing actual work in this class. Just let every discount in the composite discount apply to the original price in parallel. That is what this class is supposed to do. And it's over. Why am I so sure that this is right? Well, because if you look above, the only way for you to get access to an instance of this class is for the factory method. And factory method will never let you lay a hand on a bare instance of this class, but only an instance which is decorated with a capping decorator. So it must be correct. But this is not the end. I have another idea for you to see. When you start walking this path, it never ends. There's no end to surprises and to improvements you can make when you start combining design patterns. Let me show you, but before that, if you liked this video so far, please press the like button right now. That will help me promote this video. Thank you. Let me show you one trick. What if some discounts in this sequence on the input are null objects? Why keep them? Why make calls to null object implementations when they are obviously not going to do anything? That would be wasting CPU cycles. Why do that? And what if some of these discounts are already parallel discounts? Then we should flatten them, right? Why going in depth? Why working recursively? That will also waste both memory and CPU cycles. I don't want my object to behave suboptimally. So one thing is to flatten out the nested parallel discounts. Walk through all the discounts in this sequence on the input, and if any of them is a parallel discount, then unwrap its content. Otherwise, just return it the way it is. This will ensure that there will only be one layer of discounts in the resulting sequence, no recursive calls between parallel discount objects. The other related optimization is to purge the discounts that will not affect the output. Those are certainly the no discount instances, so just move them out from the sequence before using it. And now comes the implementation of the runtime optimized version of this factory method. First, we purge the flattened sequence of discounts, and then we take a look into what we have got. So what could it be? If it is the empty list, then the result is no discount. There's no parallel discount that does nothing. This is the no discount object. That is why we have that null object implementation in this design. If it is a list with a single discount in it, there's no reason to wrap it into any composite. Just return that single object, and that is the discount you wanted. Otherwise, there must be a proper list of discounts with more than one of them inside, and then we do the heavy lifting. Wrap them into the parallel discounts object and decorate with 100% cap. Only when we have the proof that there should be a work done to run multiple discounts in parallel. Look at this static method. There we see the factory method, the null object, the composite, and a decorator, all created within these five lines of code. And as the result, when this factory method is invoked, as the result, we will get the smallest and the fastest possible object that does the job that was requested. No memory wasted, no CPU cycles wasted when this factory is used. Again, let me remind you, if you want to download this source code, it is available on Patreon. Become the patron, follow the link in the description, and download source code and see what I have done here. I'm sure that you will like it after you read it. And this is the end of this demo. I'm sure you have learned how important it is to use multiple patterns to combine them in controlled settings within a single method, so to always guarantee that the resulting object is the proper composition of implementations of different design patterns that are doing the job expected by that method in the best possible way. Combine design patterns, make your designs better, more flexible, faster, whatever you need. Thank you for staying till the very end, and see you in the next demonstration.